week for breakfast and lunchroom, we will have on Monday mini pancakes or chicken biscuit, Tuesday breakfast pizza or French toast sticks, Thursday sausage biscuit or pancakes, Friday donut or Pop-Tart. For lunch this week, we will be having Monday chicken tenders or pizza crunchers, Tuesday hot dog or cheese pizza, Thursday chicken wings or mozzarella sticks, Friday chicken nuggets or Thanksgiving lunch for kindergarten, second, and fourth grade. Thanksgiving lunch for pre-K, first grade, third grade, and fifth grades will be Friday, November 20th. Our school will be having the Veterans Day program on Monday. We will be out of school next Wednesday, November 11th, for Veterans Day. Your books are on sale from now until November 20th. The cost is $30.
Sports news. Varsity football, the Lions beat Moulton 31-7. Hayesville scored 4 touchdowns and 1 field goal. Will Evans scored 2 touchdowns. Scott McAlpine 1 touchdown. Wynn McAlpine with a pick 6. Antonio Reyes scored a field goal with 4 extra points. I'll report next week on Lions first round of the playoffs. Let's go! Buckle up! In middle school basketball, they're underway and off to a great start. The 8th grade boys have won both their tournaments they've played in. They won the Red Bay Invitational and the Tharptown Tournament. In cross country, the boys team plays second in sectionals. They qualify for state. The girls cross country team had 2 individual runners qualify for state, Allie Silas and Allie Donaldson. Good luck to all the runners. Thank you. Have a great week. Roar Lions.
Gonna do it for me. Now watch me whip. Kill it. Now watch me nay-nay. Okay. Now watch me whip. Whip. Watch me nay-nay. Why me do it?
This week, the oldest rivalry will be going down. Auburn will be playing Georgia. I think Auburn will whip Georgia by 14. Also, Alabama will be playing Mississippi State. I think Alabama will whip Mississippi State by 21. Tune in next week to see who will get whipped.
Good morning, afternoon, or evening, everyone. I'm here with your local news. Did you know that Alabama is home to 4 national forests? Did you also know that one of Alabama's national forests is in our backyard? The Bankhead National Forest covers over 181,000 acres. Last month, the Big Tree Fire spread through our forest and burned over 1,000 acres. Thanks to the hard work of many firefighters and rangers, many of the areas and trails in the Bankhead are now reopened for visitors. If you are planning a trip soon, please know that Bee Branch Trail, Sipsey River Trail, Winning Hill Horse Trail, and portions of Northwest Road Horse Trail still remain closed. Please remember the words of Smokey the Bear. Only you can prevent wildfires. That's all I have for you this week. Tune in next week for your Around the Town happenings.
Let's drop!
Yes, I'm here with your weekly roar forecast. Cooler temperatures are moving in this week. Monday is calling for early showers, highs in the mid-50s and lows in the upper 40s. Chance of rain, 30%. Tuesday and Wednesday is calling for partly cloudy skies, highs in the mid-60s and lows in the low 50s. Chance of rain, 10%. Thursday and Friday is calling for mostly clear skies, highs in the upper 50s and lows in the low 40s. Chance of rain, 20%. Hope you have a fabulous week in New Orleans.
Hello and good morning, students, staff, and locals. Today I'm going to be telling you about the leading Democratic presidential candidate, although I personally would not vote for her. Hillary Diane Rodham Clinton is an American politician who served as the 67th United States Secretary of State under President Barack Obama for 5 years. She is the wife of the 42nd President of the United States, Bill Clinton, and was the First Lady of the United States during his tenure from 1993 to 2001. Clinton also served as a United States Senator from New York for 8 years and is a candidate for President of the United States in the 2016 presidential election. Now I'm going to give you an update on the top 5 candidates in the Republican national polls. Barely in the lead is Donald Trump, Following very close behind is Ben Carson. After him is Ted Cruz, then Marco Rubio, and Jeb Bush. That's all I have for you this week. Have a great week. Remember, you have a voice to make a choice.
On November 2nd, within the short time span of 2 minutes, buildings shook, cars tumbled, and walls cracked. Officials say about 33 people were killed and about 200 people were injured in Afghanistan, and even more in Pakistan, with about 147 killed and 600 injured. So now you really know how bad earthquakes really are. That's all I have this week, but tune in for more world news.
This has been your weekly roar.